Court has ruled out that MPs and MLAs, the honorable MPs and MLAs, they are not barred from practicing as an advocate. So what is your opinion on this?
Well, of course, lawmaking and enforcement of law are not enemies of each other. It's the same job. Making of laws, you are only trying to understand the values of this contemporary society and making rules for that. You are dealing with the social evils, corruption, food adulteration, adulteration in medicine. So the lawyers enforce that law. Lawyers ask that there is not enough evidence or there is enough evidence. So I think that being a lawyer and a lawmaker is a great asset, not only to the person concerned, but the two institutions.
So you have been an advocate, you have also been, you have also worked as the additional solicitor general and a member of parliament. So we have seen you in all three forms. So what is your favorite role?
You see, I was also a law teacher.
Okay.
I find that there is no other vocation which gives you a challenge every day. And this is the only profession where you learn till you are in active practice. You remain a student. Every case is a challenge. You have to understand. You have to anticipate. Here is the judge who is presiding, and you don't know which question he's going to ask. Not only that, when he asks a question, whether the answer appeals to him or not, is just a manner, the manner in which the argument is put. So I think that this is the greatest of all professions, because it's the most difficult thing in life to be able to change someone else's mind. And that's the challenge that we take. It's easy to make up your own mind, but it's not that easy to convince others in a matter of seconds or in a matter of a couple of minutes about the worth of your case. So that's what keeps us on our toes and gives us sleepless nights.
Yes. So besides the MP and MLAs in which they were allowed to practice, Bar Council has dissented the opinion of Supreme Court in many news reports. They are of the opinion that it is against the principle of separation of power, and then also that when they are in...
Which power do we have? An advocate doesn't have a power. Separation of power is for the powers, for the three pillars of democracy.
Yes.
Legislature, executive,
and
judiciary.
Yes.
In judiciary, we are not exercising power.
Okay.
We are only pleading.
Right.
In the parliament, I as a loaner, a nominee of the president, I am completely at sea. The private members' bills that I can move have hardly ever been adopted. So we are there because we understand the system. We understand the values which the laws and the constitution propagate. And we are able to grapple with the process of lawmaking. Where is the conflict of power? A lawyer neither in the parliament, nor as a lone member in the parliament, nor in the court, is exercising power. He's only exercising his own faculties.
And is this in line with the Advocates Act also and the Bar Council rules?
Well, the Supreme Court has said that the Bar Council rules don't bar members of parliament from practicing. That's the correct law.
Mm-hmm. sir, in reference with our Delhi Police survey, we would like to put up some questions under your opinion. So, in your opinion, do you think Delhi Police actually follows rules and guidelines?
You see, we need to understand police has a very tough job to do.
Yeah.
If you have committed a crime and the police is looking for you, it's not going to be easy for them to be able to trace you. A crime is something which has happened in the dead of the night. How do you reconstruct it? You need, these days, you need the accused, the suspect. And you first thing you need is the suspect's phone. Where was he? Determine his location, which is scientifically conclusive. If he is there, then comes the next question, what were you doing? Now, all those interrogation is not evidence. But interrogation is the first step by which the investigating officer is trying to unearth the truth. It's not an easy job. He has no premonition. He has no supernatural power to be able to discover as to who came and committed the rape. So they have to, or every day, in every case, the police has to perform the unpleasant task of arresting somebody, of controlling somebody who is running away, of controlling a mob which is raining stones on them. So, it's true that our police stations in India have turned this into fine art interrogation, and that fine art is third degree. I wish that there would be more dependence on scientific evidence and less reliance on oral witnesses. Only then we are going to be able to arrive at the truth. The other thing is police being subservient to the political masters. It is a terrible interference in the task of an investigating officer in being able to make up his mind as to who committed the crime and how, in an unhindered manner. No one should be able to influence it. We need to improve our police system. Supreme Court has said a number of times, no government is willing to cede this power, because if you are a minister, your power means power over the police to use the danda. If those are our national traits, the same will be reflected in the police.
So, as we can see that normal people, the citizens of India, they usually consider police very corrupted. And since we have worked with police and law and order, so we know that their job is not easy.
Everybody is corrupt. Which vocation is free of corruption? You go to the hospital, is it free of corruption? Are the school admissions free of corruption? And so many chief justices have said that 30% are incorrigibly honest, 30% are incorrigibly corrupt, and the rest are in between. Now, if that is so, what action do we take? What's our conviction rate in corruption cases, in adulteration cases, in all the other social evils that the society is bedeviled with? The biggest handicap is that our judiciary takes far too much time to decide the case. If it is going to take 10 years for a case to be decided, there's never going to be any justice, and everybody is going to get corrupt. Corruption is because judiciary is unable to decide in I think no case should take more than 6 months. Whatever we have to do, we have to do. Justice and criminal justice is the promise made by the state that we will protect you. We will protect your life and property. They must fulfill that promise. That way criminal justice is the first obligation of the state. But what we see on the roads, the manner in which people are being lynched and the investigating process completely subverted, where the victims are being arrested instead of the perpetrators of the crime. Cow has become more holy, than a human being. So this is a complete denial of justice if nobody is going to be able to decide these cases in reasonable time.
And sir, can we say that those citizens who call them corrupted are the ones who actually at times do not cooperate in the cases where they should, because under pressure police take certain decisions like having a witness by pressure or arresting somebody else in the case, but having somebody else.
You see, police has the same problems that we have. He needs his job. He has to feed his children like anybody else. The media as well as the politician puts pressure on him. Why haven't you arrested somebody? So he goes and arrests somebody. He says it's now for the courts to decide as to whether he's guilty or not guilty. If he doesn't do that, he loses his job.